Everyone, this is the Great Pyramid of Giza, the latest Lego architecture set to be unveiled. It comes out on August 1st, 2022 for the price of $130 US, and that includes 1,476 pieces. The size of it is important to keep in mind when you're considering whether to buy this and also considering the potential value. The height, they say, is 8 inches, which is not all this, it's just something like that. It's not that huge. The width is 20 centimeters. Width is 13.5 inches, 35 centimeters. And the depth is 12.5 inches or 32 centimeters, which you have to understand includes all the other stuff, not just the pyramid itself, but the height of the base is included in that 8 inches. And the sand is included a little bit on the sides for the width. And all of this, the frontage is included in the depth. I have to say, I like the packaging here. In the presentation, this is a good looking box. You know, they kept the black thing, but I mean, just the contrast against the white, the tan, a proper color for the glow. It's a little bit warmer color even than the tan. They include the cartouche. I'm assuming that they have the correct one there of Khufu. See, two of those letters are the same. Maybe it's actually right. I don't know what that says to the right personally. I like the tan on the bottom. Packaging doesn't matter that much, but just in this case, I personally like it. And I like the fact that they made this whole thing look not the way that it does today, but rather the way it would have looked back in the day when it was freshly constructed, you know, at the height of ancient Egyptian civilization, which is really cool. The pyramid itself is covered with the white casing, which was white limestone. It was mortared up and it was practically polished back in the day, from my understanding. Originally, the exterior of the most expensive pyramids were, they would just glisten. They would blind you from a distance if the sun hit it just right. So this is nice to see. And, you know, the white is good. The tan is good. The contrast there, you got an obelisk over here. A couple of the queen's pyramids down here. My big question is, did the Nile ever come up to here? I'm assuming that during the yearly floods, it was in many places, but I don't know if there would have been boats right here. I don't know the history that much, but I'm pretty certain that the Nile itself never was here in this location, right up against the Great Pyramid of Khufu in particular. But I like how this looks, and it looks so vibrant, you know? So much more interesting than just having a basic tan pyramid. So I'm happy with it, even if there might be some historical inaccuracy here. This, though, was completely unexpected. This is not a rebuild here. It's unfortunate that this is kind of coming apart. I don't know why they didn't push the pieces together better than that, but it's nice that we're seeing what we're seeing here is based on photos and not renderings. But the fact that you can see this in its under construction form and all those parts are included for that, that's pretty nice. That's really nice, in fact. So yeah, it's just a closer look at that. You know, some of the winch system, potential winch system that may have been used for lifting the rocks as they went up and up and up. This is a half of a capstone suggested here, a gilded capstone, which from my understanding would not have actually been like that on this pyramid. The capstones, and fancy ones in particular, tended to be introduced much, much later from what I recall, if I'm not mistaken. But it looks great though. I want to see it there. And also it's a lacquered, you know, drum lacquered gold piece. But I love how you can just take this off. This is all included. There's no rebuild required to get this effect. That is good. And you can see the tiles, when we looked up close here, the tiles here on the side where things, I think a bunch of the tiles are resting points for the casing. Looking a little bit closer here at the center causeway, this is nice with multiple of the sphinxes, plural, on the side. Got the white gear pieces here. This technique used again with the 1x4. Where was that first used though? Forget, one of the architecture sets used that. don't remember which one it was, but it's a really nice technique that works out well with the 1x4x1 panel pieces. This is just so vibrant. The trees, as simple as they are, they look good, you know? I like it. A couple boats in there too. I like it a lot. And around the back, they did this right. This is, I don't think you could have done this any better in Lego form. And there you can see the interface between the casing, you know, kind of the shell that you can remove, and the inner under construction spot. So that's all really good, if you ask me. The problem is that this is indeed, to get that cutaway view, the entire thing is cut away. And this picture right here is a bold-faced lie. I can say that because there's no indication on the screen of the fact that what you're seeing here is two kits. There's no suggestion of the fact that this is two kits. As a matter of fact, it's slightly deceptive. I don't think it was intentional for it to be deceptive that the folks doing the photo shoot specifically took one kit with the casing off and one with the casing on. They just wanted to show some contrast there, so it wouldn't look as boring. You know, there's just more visual interest there. But I think that this should have been caught before this image was published with no annotation whatsoever. Because what you do have to do to have two halves is buy two kits, and then you would have the casing over here. You have the casing over here. You take the casing off of both, and then you have two under construction halves of a pyramid which you put together and looks like one, which would be actually really cool to have them together. But this is not a full pyramid set. I think it's important for that to be underscored and understood rather than this being the best indication of what it looks like in a realistic setting, not directly from the back, you know, where you're actually seeing it at an angle. This is correct here. Oh, look, we're in the bunker again, just with warmer lighting this time for the background. So they're using a lower color temperature, or they've adjusted the white balance to a lower color temperature because they want to give you that adventuresome feel, you know, and more wood tones and earth tones feel more adventurous. I wonder if they just repaint this whole place on a regular basis for different shots, but it's mostly just gray. But it's just interesting to see that's literally in the concrete bunker room again. But this thing displays really nicely, and the argument could be made that this is actually the fact that it's flat on the back, flat and vertical, cut straight through, is actually that's funny. A service, a bit of fan service, because you want to be able to push this all the way up against a wall or against the back of a bookcase or something if you don't have a whole lot of space. But within the same space, they could have instead made a pyramid, a whole pyramid. And guess what? Pyramids are flat at the base, so it would still go flat up against something. I don't see anything. A little bust of Nefertiti there. It's really, is that a recyclable insert from like a Sonos, like a Sonos speaker box or something? This is something you throw away, I'm pretty sure. I like to make fun of this stuff. Oh, this is LDF. It's low density fiberboard that's been painted dark green. This is really terrible material. Awful. It's clearly never been in an area that has any moisture. Otherwise, it would be warped to heck and back. How do you make furniture out of LDF? It must be stabilized or something. That's just really weird to me. Sorry, I'm actually genuinely curious about stuff like that. Okay. Sorry, I need to turn off the music there so I don't get any copy strikes. Okay. Interesting that previous shot was a handheld shot. This one is not. Another handheld shot. Hey, they're trying to make it feel more real. Different white balance for... I wonder if this is with the exact same lighting. So, yeah, I bet you it is the exact same lighting. So I think those pictures are just color graded. See, that is all lies. This is true. This is truth here. All truth. Are those mold marks? Are those cut marks on the side? Prototype pieces, maybe? It's just so obvious. That's weird. I've never seen that. Those two little marks like that, those scars, to that degree on those pieces. But this is a lie. This should very clearly say on the screen, requires two full sets. Second set purchased separately, something like that. By law, for advertisement purposes, you have to do that. They messed up. Intentional or not, they messed up. It is nice that they thought about putting two together so that you can actually have a great pyramid out of your great pyramid set. But you do need to buy two great pyramid sets to get two pyramids. You should just be clear about that. Truth in advertisement is important. There's a reason that there are rules about that. Oh, wow. The rendering looks very different. Look at the surface. Look at the surface right there. The glare, where the glare comes through, how flat that is compared to the picture. Wow, like it was. Yeah, right in there. You can see the gradient of the artificial glare. It's kind of cool, but it's also, speaking of truth in advertisement, these photographs, is this a photograph or a rendering? I think that's a photograph. You can see all the gaps there, but this, yeah, this, check that out. Look at all the different depths there. That I respect. If they did this intentionally as a photograph in order to show the actual texture of the parts, including the fact that they don't fit together perfectly, these different generations of designs, corners versus the middle. Also, it's just really interesting. The imperfection is good to show because it's real. I support that very much. $130. I personally would have preferred to have a complete Great Pyramid in one. Or could have made it smaller, less of the frontage stuff, and then encourage people to buy two. Let's see what they say about buying two. Sphinx statues, creative fun. Can be connected to a second model sold separately for a full pyramid shape. That's true. Okay. Does that... yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep, good stuff. Good stuff, just the pictures not so great, and I think it would have been better as an actual pyramid. Let me know what you think about that. Full pyramid versus half pyramid with more stuff up front. Either way, you got to pay your way to play. And I do think that this looks really, really good and way more interesting than just a modern day realistic tan pyramid. But it's a trade-off. Let me know your thoughts about that. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.